And in this massive convoy, all these delegations who've been invited to come to Syria. Here's a gentleman rolling a cigarette with his sandals and shorts and a bright white t-shirt on. And what's your name?
My name's Mike Raddie from London.
And what are you doing here, Mike?
This is my third trip to Syria. And predominantly, I'm here to show my support for the Syrian people. But I'm also here to talk to Syrian people, bring their voices back home, the voices that are so often unheard in Western corporate media.
And what are you here on your own, or do you represent a group?
I'm actually here with my co-editor, Alison, from BSNews. BSNews, yeah.
And BS is what we think BS stands for.
Yes, exactly.
Does that mean that your news is BS, or you're about...
No, this was our ironic title that we chose in frustration with mainstream media 5 or 6 years ago.
And with that, you include me as the BBC and mainstream media.
Absolutely, yeah. One example of that is that you never refer to the Syrian government. So I think it's a coalition government at the moment, but you never refer to it as the government.
We do.
It's always referred to it as the Syrian regime.
No, I think you should, that's a little bit of BS too. So tell me, what are the voices that that you don't hear, you believe?
Okay, so Syrian people in general support their government. They certainly support the Syrian Arab Army. And we have to face facts that the Syrian Arab Army is made up of sons and daughters and brothers and sisters, uncles and aunts and cousins from all over Syria. So it's obvious that they support them, they love them and they respect them. It's the Syrian Arab Army that is keeping the people safe, effectively. That's predominantly what I've heard. The other thing I've heard
is... most mainstream media will cover the voices from Syria, the kind of voices that you said, who do support the government, support President Assad and the army, but they also cover those Syrians who don't support the army and the president. It's a society of many voices.
Yeah, but I think the majority support the government, and it's the vast majority.
It's hard to say. I mean, this is a country at war. It's hard to have a very scientific idea.
Yeah, that's very true, but there was a presidential election in 2014, and Bashar al-Assad won effectively twice the size of the mandate that Theresa May is currently running on. And even prior to the 2014 election, NATO did their own internal report and came to the same conclusion that about 70%, it's a little bit higher now, that 70% support the government currently.
And what do you think will be the message of this National Day and this celebration in Aleppo?
I think it's basically that the West, Mr. Trump and Mrs. May, they can do what they want with their cruise missiles, but the Syrian people will never be divided. It's a really defiant people. And for them, it's Syria or death. That's their identity. That's the way they see their lives.